Namaste children, this video is for class 3 subject science chapter 6 continuation of feeding habits of animals part 2 video. Children, I welcome you all for today's science class. Children, shall we see the small recap about the previous concept? Based upon the feeding habits of animals, we can classify the animals into herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Animals which eat only plants are called as herbivores. Say for example, cow, goat, deer, etc. These animals are called as herbivores because they eat only plants. Animals which eat the flesh of other animals are called as carnivores. Example, lion, tiger, wolf, they attack other animals and they will eat the flesh of other animals. Animals which eat both plants and animals are called as omnivores. Example, human beings, bear, crow, etc. They are the examples of omnivores. Children, now let us see about feeding habits of different animals. As I said earlier, some animals eat only plants, some animals eat the other animals, some animals eat both plants and animals. Different animals eat different types of food, isn't it? The kind of food they eat depends upon the shape of their mouth, jaws and teeth. If you see some animals, they have the sharp teeth. Some animals have a long sticky tongue. So, different kinds of animals eat different kinds of food based upon their shape of their mouth, jaws and teeth. If you see some animals, they swallow their food, some animals chew their food, some animals tear their food, some animals suck their food. Now let us see about some animals swallow their food, such as example frogs. Frogs eat insects such as flies, moths, snails, worms, etc. See this children, see this picture, they use long tongues and sticky saliva to catch their prey, isn't it children? Lizards also carnivorous children. They eat ants, spiders, isn't it? Do you know children? Snakes can eat animals which are bigger than them in size. Frog, lizard and snake do not use teeth to bite or chew their food. They swallow their food. Frogs and lizards catch their prey with the help of a sticky tongue. They have sticky tongue children. The snake can open its mouth very wide to swallow its prey. Now let us see about some animals chew the cud. Children, have you all seen the cow and buffalo? Always it will be chewing the food, isn't it? Means it is chewing the cud. What is cud children? Cud is a portion of food that returns from an animal's stomach to the mouth to be chewed for the second time. For the first time, it will swallow the food partially and again the food will return back from the stomach to the mouth. So, for the second time, again it will be chewing. So, animals like cow, buffalo, camel first nipple their food and put it inside their bodies. When they relax, they bring back the part of the food from the inside into their mouths. They then chew it properly. That's why always when you see cow and buffalo, always they'll be chewing, isn't it? So then they chew it properly. This is called chewing the cud. So animals have very strong and broad back teeth which helps them to chew. If you see the teeth of buffalo, cow, camel, they have the strong and broad back teeth. So, it helps them to chew the food. Some animals tear their food. Children, have you all seen the dog and cat? They tear their food and they will eat their food because they have the sharp pointed front teeth. Animals like Lion, dog, fox, cat first tear the flesh with their sharp pointed front teeth. Their teeth will be very sharp so that it will help them to tear the flesh. Then they chew it with their grinding teeth. Now let us see about the animals gnaw their food. Children, you have to pronounce this G-N-A-W-S, gnaw. What is gnaw? Bite something repeatedly. See this picture, children. Which animal is this? Rabbit. Which animal is this? Squirrel. Which animal is this? Rat. So if you see this animal, they have the sharp front chisel-like teeth. So this teeth will help them to bite even hard and rough food grains and other food items. So such animals are called as gnawing animals. So gnawing means the animals which will bite something repeatedly are called as gnawing animals. Animals suck their food. Children, see this picture. What is this? Butterfly. Have you all seen the butterflies in different colors? We all love butterflies, isn't it? And butterflies used to suck the honey from the flowers. So insects like butterfly, mosquitoes and leech have a long hollow tube like structure. So this structure will help them to suck their food. So if you see mosquitoes also, they used to bite and they used to suck the blood, isn't it? Leech, what is leech, children? Leech is a worm-like insect which feeds by attaching itself to some other animals and suck its blood. Children, do you know an elephant uses its trunk to pluck leaves and push them into its mouth? Its trunk also helps it in sucking water. See this picture. What this elephant is doing? Elephant is taking bath with the help of the trunk. So trunk also helps it in sucking water, to take bath and to pluck the leaves, and it will push them into its mouth. In the next class, we will see about how to take care of animals. That's all for today's class. Thank you, children. Keep smiling.